Connecting to a vehicle, first identify the plug and plug in physically. After this, identify the layout and color on the screen. This is called the vehicle system scan. It will scan the full vehicle without the need of going system by system. You will have the options of scan system or scan and read full codes. We will select the full option. You can save your settings and keep the settings stored for future connections. During this process, Geltest is scanning the vehicle, going through all the ECMs present in the vehicle and identifying them. After identification, it does another recognition and pulls out the fault codes that are present in the vehicle. So in about a minute of time, you have all the systems that are present in the vehicle and the fault codes, along with their status. This provides a vehicle system scan, a full overview of the vehicle and its fault codes. Once you have the full vehicle overview, you can proceed to expand all errors. This is a snapshot of all the systems, all the codes, and the status. A very intuitive solution to quickly diagnose your vehicle in detail. OEM fault codes. Scanning again. Reading, erasing, and reading OEM fault codes. Frequent tests. Here we can see a selection of the most common tests for the systems that appear in this vehicle. If you want to go straight to a cylinder cutout, this is the way. Operation data allows a quick access to the data from the truck, a quick reset as well. VIN info shows all the relevant information from the vehicle, manufacturing plan, engine model, and so on. Manual identification allows you to access the generic information when a specific system has not been identified. Basic live data shows the most relevant measurements from the vehicle. You also have the option of selecting the instrument view and visualize the gauges just like on the real truck. The report preview will allow you to visualize everything that has been done so far on Geltest. For a quick diagnostic analysis and printout, we can connect and print the report. Once in the report, you can see detailed systems, fault codes, save the file, print it, as well as increase or decrease the size of visualization. Export to telematics will allow you to share information with fleet managers in the future. Connecting to a specific system, the engine, we select the expand button and see automatically all the fault codes associated to that system. We select the triangle button and get a direct access to the fault code analysis. From left to right, we see the status of the code, the proprietary information on the fault code, the amount of repetitions, and a description on what the code is. After this, where Geltest becomes a game changer, the icons on the right, with I for freeze frame data, question mark, with help about the components, and our market-leading step-by-step troubleshooting guides. Once the code is selected, we go to the freeze frame data, showing information on what the fault occurred. In help and components of the fault code, you can see the component image, description, location, and operational values. The last icon allows to access the wiring diagrams. These diagrams are available for all systems and are consistent in layout and information throughout the software. Once the wiring diagrams are accessed, the selected component appears highlighted. When you hover over the component, you can see the image as well as the detail of the pinouts and how it is connected to the ECM. When selecting the ECM, the same scenario repeats itself. You have the image, and when clicked on, shows you the detail of the sockets and the pinouts with a number count so you can identify the proper pins. Going back to diagnostics menu, we proceed to the fault code troubleshooting. The top product in step-by-step troubleshooting, where the procedures are linked to the code and embedded directly in the software. Each step has an expandable plus sign and gives you steps, images, or operating values relating to solving the issue. When you see hyperlinks associated to actions, it means that the software takes you directly to where the action needs to be performed. Once this is done, it will bring you back to the troubleshooting tree. In this case, going to the region, it first asks to validate your expert mode code, required every time you're doing delicate operations. After this, our three-step process First, an explanation of what you're doing, a reason in this case. Second, the initial conditions that need to be met. And finally, the launch and operation of the action. Once finalized, you will be taken back to the troubleshooting tree and proceed with the next step. The last step will always be clear fault codes, and you're done. Now, we will connect to the engine system to see all the options available that are specific to this system. Inside the specific system, you can see the scroll down bar with all the available functionalities, from system data, ECU info, parameters, a key area where speed, idle speed, and many more options can be modified. Monitoring will give us information of the live feed of data from the vehicle. System checks and actuate components allow you to activate functionalities and check that they are functioning properly. Maintenance gives you all the recent capabilities and filter resets. Calibration, with a core aspect which is injector calibration, a simple 2-minute process that supports trim files as well. A configuration option where you can manage passwords and then the operation data for the vehicle based on partial or total travel time. One of the key functionalities in the software is the search of actions. It allows you to target your desired action without having to look for it, saving you time in the first steps of utilization. As we can see, with VGT, it takes us to the action and also shows the calibration and installation options, allowing us to target our desired functions easily. Now, to go back to the vehicle overview, we press the disconnect button and can choose a new system to connect to. The buttons on the left are the JALTAS information buttons. System technical data provides information about the component's location, what they look like, and some of the operational values, such as timing torques, pressure values, and much more. In the diagram section, we will connect to all the possibilities available for this system. As noted in the legend, we have wiring diagrams, operating diagrams, fuse and relay diagrams, and block diagrams. Here we select the wiring diagrams and see the layout of the components and their pinouts. We have the option of searching for components within the wiring diagram. In this case, we will search for components containing the word oil. When we search, we see the two components with oil. We click on the oil pressure sensor and it takes us to that component, highlighting it to make it easier to identify. When you hover over it, the image appears, and by clicking on it, we get access to the image of the component and the operating values. Continuing with the diagrams, we're going to select the operating diagram related to the DEF system. With a slightly different layout, we see it functions the same, giving us images when we hover over the elements and showing us a detailed flowchart. On the top right, we can select another configuration and jump to another type of diagram. In this case, the communication bus shows us how the CAN lines are connected to the different ECUs and gives us the respective images. The last available diagram is the fuses and relays, where we can see all the fuses in the cabin and what each one is. The same thing being available for the relays. Vehicle service data.
This functionality allows the user to consult and access relevant maintenance reports, which can be utilized to carry out vehicle service at the shop.
Vehicle technical data. We have to select the specific information from our vehicle, in this case the engine type. We can find the details in VIN info. Once open, we can see all the options available for engine distribution to adjustments, measurements, and the very detailed timing torques. Troubleshooting by symptoms takes you to a step-by-step procedure on solving a problem that does not generate a fault code. Works in the same way as troubleshooting trees, allowing you to go step-by-step and check the functionalities that are most probable cause for the problems generated. Releases and procedures, or TSBs, is the area where we introduce the information from OE updates, callbacks, and whatnot, either in the form of a technical communication or in the form of a step-by-step procedure. With this, we have finished evaluating all the options. Pressing the home button, we will leave the vehicle and go back to our main screen. Ready to go for another diagnostic session with JALTAS Diagnostics.